Now, remember the movie comedy duo Jay and Silent Bob? Well, Jason Mewes is the very vocal half performing alongside his best mate, Kevin Smith. And it's through this controversial character that Jason has earned cult-like status right around the globe. Jason joins us in a moment, but first, let's take a look at him in action.
Little kid, you're here. Your buddy's right here. You just stand there and react. Don't say anything, especially you. All right, people.
That's pretty funny.
Lock it up, we're going for pitcher.
All right, on a count of three, we rush these f***ing and beat the shit out of them, because if they're all f***ed up, they can't make that movie, right? Ready? One, two, three.
Goodwill Hunting 2, hunting season, scene 16, take 5.
Think about the paycheck.
Okay.
Jason Mewes joins us now from our Brisbane studio. Welcome to the studio, team.
Hello.
I just loved you in Clerks, or Clarks as we say it here in Australia.
Yes.
But an acting career wasn't always on the cards for you. How did you go from being a roofer to an actor?
It's fine. Roofer. So Kevin and I went to the same school. We grew up a block from one another, and that convenience store, actually, where Clerks was shot, Kevin worked there every day, and I was roofing, like you said. But on Sundays, we had the Asbury Park Press, which was a morning paper, and it was like 7 or 8 different piles that you'd have to put together, and I was the only one that would wake up with him at 4:30 in the morning and put them papers together. And anyway, so we'd hang out at that store all the time, and he's like, hey, I wrote a part for you. I think you're funny, you're obnoxious, you do weird stuff, and I wonder if other people find your humor funny. So he wrote the movie, and he wrote our characters in there. Well, he really wrote my character. Actually, he was supposed to play Dante, but he didn't want it to memorize all that dialogue and direct. But he still wanted to be in the movie, and he wanted me to be able to interact with someone. So he thought Silent Bob was perfect because he didn't have to memorize dialogue, but he got to be in the movie, and it gave me someone to interact with. So, but yeah, he just thought I was funny, and thought, hey, I think I want to see if other people find you funny. So
I've got to say, Jason, I just love Silent Bob, and I wish so many more of my friends were like Silent Bob. What's it like? You said, of course, you and Kevin are really good friends, but what's it like actually playing opposite someone who doesn't say anything?
It took a little getting used to, but again, I feel like the dialogue and what goes on, it's just me. It's really just someone to play off of, like his reactions, and someone to interact with. The funny thing is, you know, he's the total opposite in real life. Like, he doesn't, if you ever get to do an interview with him, you'll see that you'll get to say one word, one question you'll ask him, and 20 minutes later, he'll be finished answering that question, and that'll be the end of it. He's a lot more chatty than I am in real life. But again, it's fun. It just gives me someone to interact with, and again, I feel like we've done it so much and we know each other well enough that, I don't know, it's been a lot of fun. I didn't expect 20 something years later to still be, you know, doing stuff. We do our podcast, Jay and Silent Bob Get Old. You know, we have our show, Comic Book Men, that's at our comic book store in New Jersey, Red Bank, New Jersey. Called Jay and Silent Bob Secret Stash, and I had no idea that it would be still going, things would still be going on so many years later. So,
well, it was funny, that's why it was very funny. Now, you had challenges when you were growing up, and you yourself have been very open about the struggles that you have had with substance abuse. Can you give us a sense of how bad it really got for you?
I'm trying to think about it. All right, so right before I've over 6 years now, and I had almost 5 years, and then I got I relapsed for about a year. But anyway, the 2001 or so, I was living with a girl in Huntington Beach, and we hadn't paid rent in about 3 months, and they were about to put a padlock on the door. We had no lights, electric, or anything, and it was Christmas time, and I remember we had our Christmas tree with no lights that could turn on, and we had candles to light the living room. That's the only way we could see is candles. And the bathroom was upstairs, and it was too dark to get upstairs, so I used to urinate in this bucket. We fell asleep. We nodded out really from doing drugs, and we woke up and our couch was on fire. And the first thing I grabbed was the bucket, and I just threw this bucket of urine on the fire. And so it was pretty bad. We were living in an apartment with no heat, no electric, no, you know, we had candles, our couch caught on fire. There was urine all over the place. It wasn't pleasant. And that's when I finally was like, I need to go to New Jersey. And I had a warrant out for my arrest, and I was scared to deal with it, but I knew that they'd either put me in jail, and I was hoping for not a long time, or rehab, and that's sort of, I felt like what I needed at that point, because it was that bad that I was like, one of these things are gonna force me to get sober. So that's what I did, and they gave me 6 months in rehab, and then I got out, and then I moved, that was in New Jersey. Moved to California and so it got pretty bad. We were this close to being homeless. Again, we only, we technically were homeless, but we were able to, you know, sort of freeload in the apartment for as long as we could.
Now, were you a father at this stage?
A father? No, I wasn't.
Have helped you becoming a father and a husband to get through this, to help you get sober?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, again, it was, I think I hit a point, so that, then I got sober, and then I met my wife that I'm with now. We dated for like 3 years, then we got married. I did actually relapse while we were still together because I had to get surgery, and they gave me pain medicine, and it sort of started that beast again. Our baby's 19 months old. Her name's Logan Lee. And like I said, it's been over 6 years now since I've drank or anything like that. So.
Yeah, that's great.
Thank you.
Addiction is a lifelong struggle, mate. So good on you for staying on that path. Now, I've got to talk to you just quickly about the other big thing that's happening in the States at the moment. Donald Trump has been voted president-elect. What are your thoughts on him and what it'll mean for America?
I have no thoughts on it, really. I'm not into the whole, I've been sort of just trying to be ignorant about the whole thing. My wife's really into politics, and she was really bummed. It's something I just don't really talk about, because A, I don't know a whole lot about it, and I just try to stay away from that, because I try not to upset either my wife or anyone else. So, yeah, I think it's just safer to stay away from that.
Probably a very good idea right about
your
now.
Wife is stunning, by the way. You've done very well.
Thank
there.
Thank you.
And Jason will be at the Supernova convention this weekend in Brisbane. All the details are at supernova.com.au. Jason Mewes, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.